Hello and welcome to another ASRC Oval Series race, and well, we're at an oval circuit. No, we're at a road course. Yes, we're normally at ovals, but now we're at a circuit, road course. Yes. Over circuit. That makes it sound like we're doing a roval or something, but no, it's the I'm gonna butcher the name. I don't even want to try to say it. I know it's simple. It's just trying to read it. It's just my brain and reading it. I can't really do it. But homie, some people are quick. I am notoriously bad at road courses and, you know, just road cars and stuff like that. And you add a street or a stock car, or you know, an over car on top of that, it's not really that good. So I'm probably gonna have like one of my worst results of the season from tonight, but I am
exit. All right, Corey, we've got 2 laps to get the job done,
but we're gonna do it and gonna see. Oop. Already? All right. Yeah, I got that how I want it. Okay, good. Alright, let's try qualifying and see how this goes. I know that this ran for official on ARCA. This, if you can't tell, this oval series tries to run as close to the actual like iRacing ARCA series as possible. With a few exceptions. But with a few exceptions, but and we usually try to have one, oh shit, we usually try to have one road course in the season as well. And this just so happened to be it, since it was in the official schedule. Oh shit, no. I thought I was going to go off track there.
P8, that puts you 3.9 off the leader's pace.
Alright. I know we can improve on that time. Oh god. Lock up. A pretty bad lock up.
currently 3.8 off the pace.
Yeah. Everyone got under a minute. I'm stuck at 101. Because that was pretty much my limit. Still though, even though I'm massively going to be under pace, I am going to I'm going to still compete and see.
That's the end of the session, P8.
And see if anyone else messes up. Who else? Only one person isn't in here. Alright. OBS looked a little funky there. I hope everything was all right. Huh. The audio bars look kind of glitchy.
Good luck.
Good luck seeing pile up and turn before the holidays. Track temp is 33.
All right. Okay. It looks like OBS is doing all right, or better now. As far as the auto thing.
We need to follow car number 93 in the left column.
Oh yeah. There's the stupid start thing.
Okay, Corey, get ready. Go, go, go! Right side. Still there. Clear right.
Alright. No one got caught up in any trouble at the beginning. That's good. My god, this car is fucking so on a dime edge around here. Yeah, it's fine though.
just done it. 59.0.
It's gonna be a long race. And to be honest, if we finish dead last, I guess we finish dead last, but I don't see someone not wrecking in this time. Yeah, like say, someone in front of me made a mistake. Not directly in front of me, but I think it was Gardner who, like my pit crew, or like my pit crew chief said over the radio, made a mistake.
So Murphy ahead is now 5.4.
That was such an early late, or early late, no, that was such an early shift for that corner. And that, this particular part, that is so difficult for me. Funnily enough, I started playing Gran Turismo 4 recently, and as anyone who has played this that game as much as GT4 will know that this track is heavily featured in that game, as you can see it in the billboard, even in this track. But even in that game, even in that old ass game, that little comp, or that little corner right there, or not this, but right after that, that slope, that hairpin corner, always gets me. I need to think about trying to pick up the pace a little bit more.
The gap to Murphy in front is now 7.7 seconds.
Yeah, that corner right there, I just, can't.
Okay, Corey, you just cut the track. There's an incident in turn four. It looks like Murphy. Yellow flag. There's an incident in turn six. We think it might be Gardner. E9.
I know I'm driving this track all wrong. I don't really know how to drive it right. So I'm just driving it as comfortably as I can. I can imagine that there's a lot, like tons of faster lines, and I probably shouldn't be as braking as early as I am, and it's exactly as where I am and stuff like that. And I shouldn't exactly be turning in when I am and stuff like that. And I should probably be committing to like full gas right there and stuff. My God, we're only on lap 11. No matter what, I knew I was going to go a lap down. To be fair, I'm not exactly like losing this guy in front of me at a rate of knots. Like all that much, it seems like, at least. Like, don't get me wrong, I'm never going to catch him, but if he does make another mistake, or, you know, something along those lines,
gap to Murphy ahead is now 5.1.
Yeah. It's so much better getting going to gear first gear for that corner just like this one.
Hess is now leading.
What do you mean, P8?
Incident in turn 5. Looks like it's Gardner.
That was kind of weird how the relative was. I don't know if first place was like kind of glitched out of existence there for a second. Or if another place caught, I don't know. I don't know what happened there. Oh no! That's why. Damn it. That sucks for Brian, because he was really fast at this track and at road courses. Holy shit. Did he go off or something? I did notice a car in front of me all of a sudden. How many tires did we get? Two? I'm kind of amazed I haven't been lapped yet.
Eighth place.
Oh no.
Stewards have warned us about track limits. Keep it between the lines.
That was almost a whoopsie.
Incident in turn one. Looks like it's Murphy.
Oh, me.
Seventh position. The gap to Murphy behind is increasing. It's now 3.6. Blue flag. The next car is Gardner. Blue flag. Right side's clear.
Thank you, 24.
Yeah, there's not really that many good places to let you go here.
No worries, we got bike lane there.
Okay, Corey, ignore that hooker and mirror, stick to your line, nail those exits. Quicker than you, entering turn 8.
Yeah, I'm not exactly gonna fight him if he makes a move. Oh my god, this car is becoming so difficult to drive. Whoa. Yeah, I'm not exactly trying to... Ooh, there he goes.
Clear right.
If he was actually able to get alongside me, I was probably, I'm gonna probably have to get or back out.
Side's clear.
Thanks.
Car on your right. You are clear on the right. Car on your right. You're still there. Clear on the right.
D7. Incident in turn one. We think it might be Murphy.
My god, that was so treacherous, trying to navigate through all of the lead lap calls, cars and stuff.
We've been warned about track limits.
Whoops. Remember, your tires are gonna be dirty after that. Gravel and shit. Broke way too early for that, but I kind of lost my braking point, so I got scared. My only real hope is for someone to DNF in front of me, and for me not to, DNF myself. Because I think the person behind me is heading off. I think he's had enough for tonight. Which, to be honest, I'm having a feeling someone's gonna bin it by the end of this race.
Turn four, it looks like Murphy.
Oh, actually, I guess Murphy isn't. Yeah, I didn't see Murphy actually leave the session, but I didn't see him on track. Oh, well, there he goes. Gardner. Oh, I just realized that the fuel thing didn't pop up. Oh well. We're gonna have to come in and refuel at some point, and so might as well get tires as well. I'm fine.
All on your left. Left side's clear.
Sorry about that. I almost swerved back on Brian there. Holy shit.
Incident in turn four. Looks like it's Finney.
Not gonna lie, that was kind of like one part of me, like trying to get my car, you know, back. Trying to get, you know, my car back into sense, and another part of me not paying attention.
Blue flag.
That turned out a little bit worse than I thought, but whatever. How many do you go? 45? Yeah. I'm thinking more along the lines of pitting on lap 45. At least lap 45 for me, it's probably going to be like lap 47 for the leaders by the time I get to lap 45. Hey, slow and steady doesn't exactly win the race, but I mean, it at least wins me positions, I find, in the end. On some occasions. Not all of them, but on some.
Please, Corey.
Okay, good. Well, not that I, you know, went off the track, but good that I was able to rejoin.
You think it might be Gardner?
Rejoin safely.
Side's clear.
Thank you.
Right. Yeah, I would have let him let him on the hairpin, but I didn't want to cut across the corner right then and there.
The has an incident in turn 4. We think it might be Gardner.
Need to go down to first there.
The car in front is Gardner.
Yeah, some of the leaders are starting to come in now. I've been feeling the tire wear steadily, but now I'm really starting to feel it. So I can understand why some of the leaders would want to come in. Hell, I kind of want to come in, but with how many laps there is to go. Yeah, it just now hit halfway. To be fair, I've been locking up like that quite a bit. So,
turn 9, it looks like Gardner.
Has he pit yet? No.
The leader, Hess, is pitting. Okay, Corey, we're at the halfway point. We think about 19 laps of fuel left. incident in turn 9. Sixth place.
Oh, I wonder if Jason got like a meatball or something. Yeah, because he's been in there for quite a while now. I wonder what happened to Brian and Jason. I mean, Brian, he got disconnected, so I wonder if he's just parking it up, or if he actually went off and something actually did happen.
Car on your left side. You are clear on the left.
Thank you, Corey.
Let's go to lap 50, let's say, or actually no, we're losing too much time like this. I don't want to say too much time because we're not exactly fighting anyone ahead of us, but oh yeah, Not this lap, but next lap.
There's an incident in turn 9. Looks like it's Maro.
Actually, Yeah, I'm wanting to stay out as long as possible. It's just because there might be a random incident that causes a full course yellow. And plus, Jason and
V6.
Brandon tend to, or is in the pits for a long time, so like the longer I'm actually out on the circuit, the more laps I'm actually like gaining on them before even coming into the pits.
Right side's clear.
Blue flag. Limiter. Okay, Corey. Box in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Box now.
Oh, that's actually a lot of optional repairs. Holy shit.
It's clear.
All right, how many laps to go? 27. Already done more than that, so we should be good.
5, blue flag.
I somehow got up into 5th place, how? What happened? Didn't go up a gear. I can't believe it. We actually have a possibility of getting a P5. I didn't go down in second gear, right? We're not on no tires. Whoa. That was a bad idea. That was a big lockup. My god, I'm sweating, like, so much that it's getting down into my left eye. And it sucks. Just under 20 to go.
Turn one.
I don't know why I keep on wanting to go down to second gear. I mean, it is a good gear to go down to if you're on, like, you know, about 40 lap Euro or 40 lap tires. Why did I say Euro? My brain. Oh shit. I might actually come in towards around 10 to go and just get more, I guess, some fresh rubber just for the ease and sake of mine of it.
Stay between the lines, please, Corey.
Nelly. Why did I do that again? I must say though, I did not expect to get a top 5 finish from this race whenever I started it.
Flag. Car on your left. Clear left. Blue flag.
Thank you.
What? Yeah. He was saying thank you. I was kind of going what with something else, so. Whoops.
stay behind you. Don't chase them down.
Sure.
Now. I'd rather you not, but you know.
Because you can definitely come past now.
Pit lane speed limit is 37 miles per hour.
It's fine, you got loads.
4, 3, 2, 1. Box now.
Alright, after this set of cars goes past, I'll hop back out. Actually, I will let the leader go past me one more time.
Looks like you're clear on the pit exit.
I should probably be, you know, only lifting on that corner, but I always go into that corner too hot. I don't know how to drive this car in this track. But somehow I'm getting fifth. Somehow.
Corey, the next car is Bell. The track temperature is decreasing. It's now
31
Celsius. That lap was at 101.5. That's your best lap in the session.
This race is about to be over, and I'm glad. This was such an exhausting race. Even though this is not like a full length race or anything like that, I mean, how can it? It's not an official ARCA series race or whatnot. But my God, does it feel like a full length race? I mean, there's no yellows or anything, it's what, about an hour and a half long? Of course, 79 laps long.
2 laps left.
With 100, I mean, like 100 miles about. Yeah. Two laps to go. Thank goodness. There it is. There is the white flag.
White flag, last lap.
Oh my God. P5 at a road course.
It's everyone. I really shouldn't have won, but that was fun.
P5. Okay, that's the finish. Well done, mate.
It happened. You're in the right spot to take advantage of the issues that happen.
Yeah, if it wasn't for, Brian's disconnect there, or packets loss, or whatnot, I wouldn't have gotten this fifth place. I feel for him, because he should have finished in front of me. I shouldn't have really gotten that P5, but like you said, capitalize on either other people's mistakes or, you know, other people's misfortunes. And well, stuff like that. Happens. I don't know. It just, my brain is too exhausted to really form coherent sentences. But I mean, that was an exhausting race. I am actually really proud of myself that I didn't just like bin it.
Engage the limiter. Box in 5, 4.
Because
3, 2, 1. Box now.
Oh my goodness, was that tough? Oh, was that so tough? To not lock up and just plow it straight into a wall, or like just get loose. And I mean, I smacked the wall pretty good. I'm really glad that didn't actually result into, you know, a meatball flag or anything like that. Oh. Well. Let's see about race incidents, shall we? Lock up. That was on lap 8, yeah, that was one of the first ones. That's kind of what I did. Yeah, that corner's tricky. Oop, loop it. Yeah, looped it. At turn one, yeah. Hit the curb a little bit too much. Yeah, that was definitely on me. I was just mindlessly like going up the road and whatnot. If that resulted in a crash, that would have been on my fault. Yeah, that would have been my bad, and or just completely idiotic for me. To be fair, how bad did that actually? Got my rear end, it looks like. Ooh, yeah. Got some pretty rough damage. Bam, ooh, smoosh. And it looks... And if I'm not mistaken, oh yeah, look, the rear of the car also got hit as well. Put a little bit too much power. Oh, whoop. Easy there. Good. Yeah, you're good. Oh, oh, oh! Oh, oh. That was a little bit of a delayed reaction from your bumper there. Oops. I kind of want to see what went on. Just kind of spit out the bumper there. Ooh, that does not look good. Oh my, yeah, that wheel. Yeah, that wheel right there does not look good. Oh yeah, it's completely dead. It's hanging off on a... Yeah, it's not even attached. I think it's detached. And I think that might be why he was in the pits for all those laps. Ooh. Okay, I see. I was like, why did it cut? I'm guessing it... I sometimes I don't understand the incidents. Okay, now is it just gonna... Okay. I think it got broken again. All right. Well, I don't think I'm gonna pull up like the results board and whatnot and everything like that. Garrett got the win, followed by Brandon Feeney again. If I was gonna say it like that, Brandon would have, Feeney would have actually gotten the win. But Johnny looks like got a podium. That's actually really great. Don't know how far is he behind in the standings for us, but Garrett, I think he's also either behind or ahead of us. I think he's ahead of us, so that doesn't exactly matter all that much. What we're really kind of competing against, off the top of my head, is Jason, and I do believe Derek and Pratt. I'm gonna have to like look at the standings again. I don't have it pulled up off the top right now, so that's totally fine. And I don't really want to pull it up, but yeah. I'm gonna leave it here. Leave it here for now. I had a fun decent race. Or that was a fun, decent race tonight. Oh my goodness, tonight. Didn't expect to get fifth. But yeah, that's just what happens whenever you arrive, participate, and just, you know, try your best to hold on and, keep it together. But yeah. Until next time, and or Talladega's next week, so in a full length race at that, so I'm excited for that because it's super speedway racing, my jam, my bread and butter. So yeah, I'm excited for that, and hope you are too. See you in the next video.